the ice, the 200 feet, in the final seconds. And a bad play up high. Palatin set it in deep. 10 seconds to go. McCarr fittingly battling for the puck in the corner. 5 seconds to go. Up it comes to the line. Colorado has won the Stanley Cup. Cup in franchise history, the first since 2001, when they beat New Jersey in 7 games. They swept Florida back in 1996, so for the second time in the 3 titles, they win it at the state of Florida. Cale Makar, brilliant, could well be just the 3rd to win the Norris Trophy and the Conn Smythe in the same year. Bobby Orr and Nicholas Lidstrom, the only 2 to pull off that double.
There's not one player in that group whose life just hasn't changed. The dream that you have is through your whole life. There's Eric Johnson in tears, the longest serving Avalanche player. Victory to the Avs.
Eric Johnson, 12 years, longest tenured Denver athlete in the professional ranks. Vasilevsky, brilliant again, Ray. I mean, only let in 2. But Kemper, who was considered by many to be the question mark on a Stanley Cup champion team, would he be good enough to have them win it? He was. And Jared Bednar has the Stanley Cup championship.
A lot of people that had a lot of questions whether Jared Bednar could coach a championship team. Well, he's done it. And he will remember this forever. Look at the respect the players have as they get to this 23-year-old superstar in Cale Makar. 2 stars in MacKinnon and Stamkos. Just an amazing series. Just a privilege to watch this.
MacKinnon so devastated last year when they went out for the 3rd year in a row in the 2nd round. One of the great traditions is the handshake line, and usually a highlight, the respect for the 2 goalies that they have for each other.
Well, how about Corey Perry? 3 straight years to the finals. The disappointment that he must feel to be on the wrong side of this. And there is Eric Johnson. 14 years.
Nazem Kadri didn't know if he'd be able to play in the Stanley Cup final. Frustrated in years gone by. Suspensions kept him out of action in previous postseasons. And John Cooper and the Lightning denied in their bid for a three-peat. Stamkos, the classy captain, congratulating Bednar. We started to tell Jared Bednar's story, right? Here's a man, we've mentioned all those years in the minors. He got into coaching as an assistant in the ECHL. Married to his wife, Susan, said, I want to be a coach in the NHL. I can't do it just staying here in Charleston. He got an opportunity in the AHL as an assistant at Abbotsford, British Columbia. His wife, Susan, and 2 kids stayed behind in Charleston. Said, I don't want to keep moving my family around. There's Susan, Cruz, and Savannah. For 8 years, as Jared Bednar went to Abbotsford, to Peoria, to Springfield, Massachusetts, to Cleveland, he saw his family almost not at all during the hockey season. Dreaming of being an NHL coach and winning a Stanley Cup.
One of the good guys, Ray. You have to feel great for him and that family.
I look at the effort, the courage to go through all of this. Look at John Cooper expressing his happiness for and respect for Eric Johnson. I look at these guys in blue. They gave everything that they could. I look at Jared Bednar, that path that you just outlined. Like, you can't even imagine how many long days there would be. Am I ever going to get here? Most of us never do. This is amazing to watch.
John Cooper knows what Jared Bednar's feeling, like Jared Bednar. You mentioned he started out coaching high school hockey, really by accident. He was going to be a lawyer. Spent time in junior hockey, in the AHL at Norfolk and Syracuse. Got promoted as an interim coach, kept the job, and has won two Stanley Cups. Crowd now saluting the Lightning. A remarkable three-year run, as we said earlier, Ray, particularly with the salary cap. I mean, they had to rebuild a lot of their team after last year's championship. And they got right back to Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final. Here's Emily Kaplan with Nathan MacKinnon.
Nate, you're a Stanley Cup champion. As you're looking at your team right now, what are you feeling?
It feels in disbelief. It's crazy. Can't wait to hug my family. It's hard to describe. I didn't really know what it'd be like to actually win it, but just seeing all these Warriors battle just feels unbelievable. So words can't describe how I feel right now.
How would you describe your journey to get here? 87. You said 87. What does that mean?
Well, yesterday my room number was 1787. So we just felt like it was fate. I don't know. We both loved Sid, and we just knew we were going to win when I got that room number.
How would you describe your journey to get to this point?
Nothing but amazing. I have no complaints, obviously. Some tough years mixed in there, but it's all worth it now. We never stop believing. The core guys have been around 10 years now. Coming at 18 with Gabe and EJ to now, it's been amazing. And it's so amazing to see guys like Cogs, Jack Johnson, all these veterans at Manson, guys that haven't won it yet. So it's insane. It's so amazing.
What's one thing you've always wanted to do with the Stanley Cup?
Just get a picture with my dad. He means the world to me. And also, I want to give a shout out to my second dad in my life, Ralph. He's going through a really hard time, and he's battling harder than we did all playoffs. So just want to give a shout out to Ralph, who I love, and I can't wait to bring the cup to you.
Thanks, Nate. I think the cup's waiting for you.
They know it in Cole Harbour, Nova Scotia. Sidney Crosby's brought it there before. Few athletes have ever been more obviously devastated after a season-ending loss than MacKinnon was last year when they got eliminated in the second round by Las Vegas. He said, "I'm going to my ninth year. I haven't won. Bleak. Poop." He's won the greatest trophy in North American professional sports. We'll be back for the presentation of the Stanley Cup right after this. The Islanders in the 80s, the original Ottawa Senators back in the 1920s, won their first four Stanley Cup finals, and the Maple Leafs won the last of their three in 1932. This is history made by this franchise. Here's Paul Porter.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the ice as NHL Deputy Commissioner Bill Daly presents the Conn Smythe Trophy to the most valuable player of the 2022 Stanley Cup playoff.
The Conn Smythe Trophy is awarded annually to the most valuable performer in the Stanley Cup playoffs. This year's winner scored 29 points in only 20 Stanley Cup games, the highest point total by a defenseman in nearly 30 years. Congratulations to the 2022 Conn Smythe Trophy winner, Colorado Avalanche defenseman Cale Makar.
to win the Conn Smythe Trophy. Second in the last 3 years. Victor Hedman won it in 2020 for Tampa Bay. The youngest defenseman to win the Conn Smythe in 52 years since Bobby Orr did it. Man to whom he is frequently compared now, back in 1970 at age 22. He's just the third defenseman 23 or younger ever to win the Conn Smythe, Serge Savard from Montreal in 1969. Once again, here's Paul Porter.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup.
Congratulations both to the Lightning and the Avalanche organizations for their terrific seasons and for giving us a spectacular Stanley Cup final. For the Lightning, this was their third Stanley Cup final appearance in 3 years. A feat that is unmatched in the NHL in nearly 40 years, and one that's never been accomplished before during the salary cap era. Congratulations to owner Jeff Binnick, general manager Julien Brisebois, head coach John Cooper, and all the Lightning players on this tremendous accomplishment. For the Avalanche, it's been 21 long years since they hoisted the Stanley Cup. But with a tremendous regular season and a dominant playoff performance, they've climbed the mountain and are on top of the mountain again. Congratulations first and foremost to the Avalanche players for their commitment, their sacrifice, and their achievement in winning the most sought-after trophy in all of professional team sports. Congratulations also to owner Stan and Josh Kroenke, general manager Joe Sakic, Chris McFarland, Charlotte Graham, head coach Jared Bednar, and the entire coaching staff. On behalf of the National Hockey League and Commissioner Gary Bettman, I have the privilege to invite Avalanche captain Gabriel Landeskog to come over and accept and hoist the Stanley Cup.
He was 19, 10th year as captain. Only Joe Sakic served longer, 16 years as captain of this franchise. Now Eric Johnson, as Ray mentioned, longest tenured Avs player, 12 years here, 14 in the league. Number one overall pick in the draft back in 2006. Andrew Cogliano, 15-year veteran. Wasn't on this team until the trade deadline.
1,140 games to realize a dream for Cogliano.
And that's just in the regular season. What a scrappy player he is. 5'10", 175 pounds. Now McKinnon. He scored the goal that tied the game. his 13th of the playoffs to tie for the playoff lead with Evander Kane. Jack Johnson, 35-year-old veteran of 16 seasons. You mentioned a couple of nights ago what a month it's been for him. He graduated from the University of Michigan 15 years after leaving. Played 2 years there for Red Barons and promised the legendary coach he'd get his degree. He did. Now he's a Stanley Cup champ. Nazem Kadri. Broke his thumb in game 3 of the Western Conference Final at Edmonton. Had surgery. They didn't know if he'd be back. He returned 18 days later and scored a huge goal. The overtime game winner here in game 4.
The move from Toronto to Colorado proved to be where his dream was realized.
A fresh start really remade his image both as a player and as a person. He'll be a free agent. It'll be interesting to see what happens to Kadri. Burakovsky, he and Helm, the only players who won it before. He hoisted the Stanley Cup with Washington. Darcy Kuemper, was he good enough to win a Stanley Cup? Yes, he is.
On the road, 2 wins in the finals for Kuemper.
And his teammates never lost confidence in him. Mikko Rantanen struggled out of the gate in these playoffs. Jared Bednar challenged him before the Western Conference Final to become an impact player. He scored a goal in all 4 games against Edmonton and a record 8 assists in the Stanley Cup Final. Darren Helm, he's the other Avalanche player who's won the Cup with Detroit. Spent 14 years there. His first year in Colorado as a free agent. Average regular season race that Coach Bednar, he was tremendous in the playoffs.
I wonder if 14 years between them, if the Cup feels the same. Amazing. There's Devon Taves. Come over for a couple of draft picks. Solidified this Avs defense and underrated, terrific player.
He got a lot of attention because he was paired with Makar. With that attention, people realized how terrific he is. That Stanley Cup is just about 3 feet tall. Val Nichushkin, 2 years ago in Dallas, played in almost 60 games without a goal or a penalty. What a postseason he's had. He certainly got Conn Smythe Trophy votes. Well, this will continue through the team. An experience that all of these players have been dreaming of since they were young boys. Here's Emily Kaplan.
Game. What did it feel like when you finally lifted that cup over your shoulders?
Oh, man, it's just, I mean, that's 20 plus years of just dreaming and wanting and working for it and just finally coming to fruition after a lot of crazy years and a lot of hard work. But this group is just amazing. And all the way from the top to our third massage therapist, to the wives, to the fans, to our, everybody working in Ball Arena. I mean, it just, it's incredible.
When you were lifting the cup, who were you thinking about?
I mean, my wife, my kids, my dad, my sisters over there. Everybody that supported me along the way, my mom, my brother, my teammates, looking at these guys. It's incredible. I still can't believe it.
The NHL is notoriously a copycat league. What do you think other teams will take away from your team's journey?
Find a Cale Makar somewhere. I don't know. I mean, listen, Joe and C-Mac have done a great job of picking up some pieces along the way that really, really made us hard to play against. You look at Cogs, you look at Helmer, you look at Sturmey, Mance. You look at all these guys, all these pieces that they just want to win so bad and they just want to do whatever it takes. And it just adds up to just a really hard team to play against.
What are you most proud of with this team?
Oh, I mean, just the resiliency. You know, just that we've had pressure on us from day one. We've been favorites from day one. The expectations from the outside, the expectations we put on ourselves inside that dressing room. to be great and to win, but take it one step at a time. And, you know, to just keep working in the playoffs and keep finding ways to win hockey games. I think we had 8 or 9 come from behind wins, and that's hard to do. And then to not really have our best game in Game 5 at home with an opportunity to hoist it in front of our fans and then come into this building and do it here, it's not easy to do. So I'm just really proud of the guys.
Text me again.